Hello children, this was 7th standard science. Term 2, unit 3, changes around us. So part 1 I have completed. Now part 2 will start with freezing. It is in page number 42. So freezing. So what is meant by freezing? So water in the freezer compartment of a refrigerator gets cooled and solidifies to form ice. So the process of conversion of liquid into solid by lowering the temperature, it will be converted into solid. Okay, so this we known as freezing. Only a change in state will appear, there will not be any new substance formed. So freezing of water is also a physical change. So freezing, what is meant by freezing? The process of conversion of liquid into solid by lowering the temperature. When you reduce the temperature, automatically the energy which is present in liquid will be decreasing and the molecules will be coming closer to each other and force of attraction between the molecules will be increasing and it solidifies. So this process we call it as freezing. Yes, so here they have explained with the use of the diagram. So particles of liquid will be, there will be some space in between the molecules in a liquid. After cooling, it will be converted into solid and it will come closer to each other. Next one is condensation. So in 6th standard itself, we have studied about the condensation. How the rain is formed? Because of the condensation. So the water which are present on the surface of earth, that is sea water, lake water, pond water, everything, because of sunlight, it gets evaporated and it goes up and it will form cloud. It will be in a gaseous state. So when it is cooling, when it allowed to cool, what will happen? It will form a cloud and it will give us rain. So here the condensation you can take place by doing some experiment. So here the conical flask is taken. Inside conical water is taken and it is allowed to cool and it is closed by means of one hole rubber cap. There one delivery tube is attached. So the gases of water, that is nothing but water vapor which is coming out from the conical flask, is allowed to touch the glass sheet or any sheet, any metal sheet or anything, and there it is allowed to cool. That time it is converted into water again. This is very easy example. When your mummy is cooking, that time you can observe, you can keep one vessel having water on the stove, and if you ignite it, when it is reaches the boiling point of water, what is the boiling point of water? 100 degrees centigrade, it is allowed to boil. That time if you keep the plate on the vessel, after 5 minutes or 10 minutes, if you open that lid, you can observe the droplets of water on the plate. Is that is nothing but condensation. So here also, what is meant by condensation? The process of changing of a gas into its liquid state, and it happens by cooling gas into its liquid state, whereas evaporation is a changing of a liquid into gaseous state and it happens on heating. So evaporation means it is doing by heating, that is liquid is allowed to heat, it will convert into gas, that is evaporation. When the gas on cooling, it again converts into liquid, that we call it as condensation. Here also water is when it is heated, it is converted into water vapor, and water vapor when it is cooled, again it is converted into water. So there is no new substance is formed, so it is also a physical change. The next one is sublimation. Sublimation is nothing but the process in which a solid is converted directly into gas without undergoing liquid state. That process we call it as sublimation, without undergoing liquid state. So best example is camphor. Here you are taking one china dish, inside it you are taking camphor and it is closed by means of funnel. So when you heat that camphor will be converted into camphor vapor and it will be deposit on the side of the funnel. Is so when that funnel should be closed by means of cotton plug. I am explaining this with here in the book it is given ammonium chloride vapors. That is, they have taken ammonium chloride and allows to sublimate. But I am explaining it with camphor. This you can do it in a home also. So only I am explaining it with camphor. Camphor means what? Kerpuram. Yes. So you are taking that camphor, and if you heat it, what will happen? It will be burning, and it will be converted into ashes, isn't it? So when you collect that ashes, and again if you cool it, you will be getting camphor again. But here we are having only small pieces of camphor, so you cannot get it. Okay, so instead of in the laboratory means they are taking ammonium chloride solution and they are heating it, and by keeping the inverter tube is nothing but funnel, is covering that ammonium chloride solution, and the other end is closed by means of cotton plug. When you heat it, ammonium chloride directly converts into vapor, and after the heating process is stopped, all the vapors which are present inside the funnel will be deposited as a solid at the corner of the funnel. So this process we call it as sublimation. The next one is crystallization. So crystallization, by doing this process, we can remove the impurities present in the crystals. So here crystallization is also a special form of physical change. The soluble impurities get removed from certain solids by crystallization. So the process of cooling a hot concentrated solution of a substance to obtained crystals is called crystallization. So we also know that seawater contains salts dissolved in it, and the salt can be separated from seawater by the process of evaporation. So the process of evaporation is not a good technique, because the soluble impurities do not get removed in this process of evaporation. For this purpose, here we are crystallizing a copper sulfate solution is given as activity. Take about 100 ml of water in a beaker, heat and the water over a burner till it boils. So add impure copper sulfate to the red hot water with constant stirring. So you have to take hot water, that is boiling stage, you have to add copper sulfate solution which is having impurities. Continue to add copper sulfate till the solution takes up the added copper sulfate, that is the added copper sulfate will not dissolve anymore. Yes, so we should prepare the saturated solution. That means the amount of copper sulfate what we are adding to water should dissolve. So filter the contents on the glass plate and allow it cool. You can see the crystals of copper sulfate in few hours, and what we are getting after this process will be purest form of copper sulfate. So crystallization is a method of separation as well as the method of purification. Okay children, is it understood? Now we'll see about chemical changes. Yes, so changes that occur with the formation of new substance with different chemical composition, or transformation of a substance into another substance with the evolution of heat or light energy, or absorption of heat or light energy, are termed as chemical changes. So if I explain with the example, you can understand easier. Okay, changes that occur with the formation of new substance with different chemical composition or transformation with chemical. So if you mix two substances, you will be getting a new substance which will not have the property of the reactants what you are taken. Okay, the substance what you are taking is called as reactants. The substance which you are getting after the changes, we call it as products. So if you get the changes that occurs with the transformation of heat or light energy, or the new substance is formed, means we call that as a chemical change. Okay, example for that one, rusting of iron, burning of paper. Yes, if you take paper and if you burn it, that paper will be converted into ashes and you cannot get it back. Okay, curdling of milk. You are converting milk into curd. After the conversion of milk into curd, you cannot get milk from curd. Is it clear, children? Reaction of baking soda with lemon juice, fermentation, or some of the examples of chemical changes. Fermentation is nothing but easy fermentation method is preparation of idli batter. Yes, you have to take rice, urud dal and fenugreek seeds, and you have to grind it before 6 hours itself. Yes, you have to grind it, and the flour has to kept as without disturbing anything. is after 6 hours or 8 hours, you can observe that after 6 or 8 hours only, the idli batter is ready to cook. Is that process, what is taking place in that idli batter is fermentation process. So chemical changes are very important in our life. All the new substances which we use in various fields of our life are produced as a result of chemical reactions. So metals are extracted from the naturally occurring compounds called ores by a series of chemical changes. So medicines also prepared by means of chemical changes. The materials such as plastic, soap, detergent, perfumes, acids, bases, salt, etc. are all made by carrying out various types of chemical changes. So every new material is discovered by studying the different types of chemical changes. Yes. The next one, in addition to new products, there may be some of the process can be done. Yes, so heat, in addition to new substance, there may be heat or light or any other radiation may be given off or absorbed. Suppose you are taking washing soda. Yes, you are taking detergent powder. Yes, and if you add some water, what will happen? You can observe heat. Okay. Instead of washing soda, if you are taking cooking soda and if you add some water, you can observe chillness. In your home itself, you can test it. So this type of reaction, we call it as exothermic reaction and endothermic reaction. In some cases, sound may be produced. Suppose if you take sulfur and if you are heated, there will be the crackling sound will be there. So that is used for making fireworks. During Diwali time, you have done fireworks, no? So there, the crackling sound will be produced. Yes, that is also chemical change. In some cases, a change in smell may take place or new smell may be given off. Yes, rotten egg, rotten vegetable, rotten fruit, you may observe some smell. That is also because of the chemical change. A color change may also take place. Suppose if you cut potato and if you keep it as such for 5 or 10 minutes, the outer layer, potato, apple, yes, brinjal, the color will change. That is also due to the chemical change. The next one, in some cases, a gas may be formed. In some cases, during the chemical change, fumes will be formed. So, explosion of firework is a chemical change. We know that such an explosion produces heat, light, sound and unpleasant gases that pollute the atmosphere. So that's why we are advised not to play with fireworks. So you must have noticed that a slice of an apple acquires a brown color if it is not consumed immediately. So here potato, slice of potato and brinjal, if you stored in water after the peeling of skin, you have to put it in water. Potato, brinjal, is banana, is rot, that is unripened banana, vadaka, is everything you have to cut it and you have to put it in a bowl of water, means the color will not change, otherwise the color will change. So this is a best example for chemical changes. So first we'll see about rusting of iron. So in class 6 itself, we have studied about the rusting is a example of chemical change. So we'll read why the process of rusting is called a chemical change. So if you can take that example, iron pillar at Delhi. There is an iron pillar at Kutubminar complex in Delhi, which is more than 1600 years age. So even after such a long period, the iron pillar kept in open spaces and has not rusted at all. So this shows that Indian scientists made great advances in metal making technology even at 16th century, which enabled them to make this iron pillar having the quality of great rust resistance. So rusting is nothing but it's a chemical change when the iron exposed to atmosphere in the presence of water vapor, iron will be converted into iron oxide. The iron oxide, we call it as rust. The new substance which is formed, iron oxide, is called rust, and this process we call it as rusting. Yes, rusting is the only change that affects iron atoms and slowly destroys them. Since iron is used in making bridges, ships, car, truck bodies and many other articles, the monetary loss due to rusting forming is very huge. So the process of forming rust is represented as follows. Iron plus oxygen plus water gives rust. Iron, the symbol for iron is Fe. For oxygen is O2 and water is H2O. Rust, that is iron oxide, is nothing but Fe2O3H2O. Attachment of water molecules will be there as a product. So for rusting to take place, both oxygen and water is essential. If oxygen is not there, it will not rust. If water molecules is not there, it will not rust. Both the things are necessary to get rust. In fact, if the content of moisture in air is high, the air is said to be more humid and eventually rusting is faster. Okay children, the next one, you can how can we prevent rusting is, so instead we are using iron in buildings and all, how can you prevent? By applying paint on it or applying oil on it, you can prevent rusting, or by doing galvanization like that. Iron articles can be prevented from making contact with oxygen or water vapor. A simple way is to apply a coat of paint or grease. These coats should be applied regularly to prevent rusting. So another way of preventing rusting is to deposit a layer of a metal like chromium or zinc on iron, and this is called galvanization, and you can learn this in the higher classes. Galvanization is nothing but applying zinc on iron. You can prevent rusting. So that process we call it as galvanization. The next one is burning. So we have already studied about the burning of paper is a fast change and also the chemical change. So burning a piece of paper gives entirely new substances such as carbon dioxide, water, water vapor, smoke and ash. So heat and light are also given out during the burning of paper. So here they are explained with help of magnesium ribbon. Is chaatai, during Diwali time, no, chaatai, that firework name is chaatai, that is nothing but magnesium ribbon, and if you burn it, it will be converted into magnesium oxide, and that is also a chemical change. So what do you observe? So you can see that magnesium ribbon starts burning with a dazzling white light. So only it is used in the form in the preparation of fireworks. So magnesium burns with oxygen to give magnesium oxide, that is a white powdery ash. The next one, curdling of milk, that you know is you have to take milk some hot milk, is you have to heat to some extent that you can touch the milk. Then if you add one drop of curd itself, after 6 hours the whole milk will be converted into curd. That is, curdling is a process in which liquid gradually turns into solid, forming clumps all the way. So take hot milk in a pan and add few drops of curd. In few minutes, what milk curdles, forming a lumpy solid masses. So we can see, even add lemon extract to the hot milk. So for the preparation of paneer, yes, nowadays you like paneer to eat, no, chili paneer, paneer butter masala, everything. How they are preparing it? They are taking milk, hot milk, is boiling milk they are taking, to that vinegar or lemon juice if you add it. So after some time, that milk will be converted into lumps. So you have to collect that lumps and you have to filter it, you have to squeeze it and put it in a polythene cover or in the cloth, and you have to keep some weight on it. So after 4 hours or 5 hours you'll be getting that paneer. Yes, preparation of paneer. And these are all the example for chemical substances, chemical changes. Okay, the next one is fermentation. So in class 6 we saw an example that preparation of batter to produce idli is an example for irreversible change. Is so irreversible change, that is, after converting into idli batter you cannot get rice again. After converting milk into curd, you cannot get milk. So these are the example for irreversible changes. So fermentation is also irreversible change. And what is meant by fermentation? Fermentation is a process in which microorganisms such as yeast and certain bacteria break down into sugar solution into alcohol and carbon dioxide. So if you see that idli batter, morning if you open that container, you can observe small holes in it. That means carbon dioxide, which are present during fermentation process, has come out through that so only that dots is appearing there. So it is an irreversible process, as alcohol formed cannot be turned back into sugar. Thus the fermentation is a chemical change. So do you know Louis Pasteur, a French chemist and microbiologist, was the first person to describe the process of fermentation? So he described that fermentation occurs in the absence of air and in the presence of microorganisms such as yeast. So he discovered the cure for rabies also. Next is chemical reaction with baking soda with lemon. So baking soda is sodium hydrogen carbonate. Baking soda is nothing but sodium hydrogen carbonate, and lemon juice contains citric acid. So when these two substances are mixed together, then a chemical change takes place between sodium hydrogen carbonate and citric acid to form three new substances, that are sodium citrate, carbon dioxide and water. So the chemical change can be written in the form of word equation as sodium hydrogen carbonate plus citric acid is gives, that arrow mark, you have to pronounce it like gives, sodium citrate plus carbon dioxide and water. This way of writing this, we call it as equation, chemical word equation. So when baking soda and lemon juice are mixed together, then the bubbles of carbon dioxide are formed along with the formation of some salt and water. So take 10 ml of lemon juice and add a pinch of baking soda to it. You can observe, when we mix baking soda with lemon juice, we will hear a hissing sound also when bubbles of carbon dioxide coming out and rising in the reaction vessel. So conditions needed for a chemical change. What are all the conditions needed to perform a chemical change? So we know that firing of crackers is a chemical change. Some crackers explode only when thrown against a wall or struck with a hot substances, or some fireworks, if you ignite it, the reaction will take place. So thus we could see that change in pressure may also bring out a chemical change. So when lemon juice is mixed with soda water, they produce brisk effervescence, which is otherwise not possible when they are separate. So the contact should be there. So we can say that many chemical changes occur only the substances are made to physically contact with each other. If you are keeping lemon juice separately and soda separately, there will not be any chemical change. If you mix it only, you will be observing the brisk effervescence. Like that, if you keep the fireworks as it is, it will not undergo any change. Yes, if you are igniting it, or if you are throwing on the wall, yes, anugundu, atom bomb, you will say no. So by applying some pressure on it, the chemical change may take place. So we have tested raw rice and cooked rice. Yes, so they are different in their state. So cooking is a process that is involved in the stated example. So wherein rice is boiled with sufficient amount of water. So it is a heat and water that has brought the change in texture and taste of the rice before and after cooking. So cooking needs heating. So heating is a condition needed for a chemical change to occur. So we know that the use of vanaspati in cooking, vanaspati is obtained from vegetable oils by addition of hydrogen to the oils. So they are converting the vegetable oils into vanaspati by adding hydrogen to it. Yes, clear children? Nickel, platinum or palladium are used as a catalyst during the process of hydrogenation of oils. So catalyst. So what is meant by catalyst? Catalyst is nothing but a substance which is added to increase the speed of the reaction without undergoing any change. Suppose if you take vanaspati preparation itself, hydrogenation of oil, that is conversion of hydrogen oil, that is vegetable oil, into vanaspati. Yes, this will take place after a long time only. To boost up the speed of the reaction, they are adding hydrogen, that is nickel, palladium to it. Platinum or palladium to it. So nickel, platinum or palladium will not change. It will just boost up the speed of the reaction. So catalyst or substances that speed up the process of a chemical change, and it will not undergo any change during the course of reaction. So for example, yeast act as a catalyst in the fermentation of sugar. So you will learn more about catalyst in the higher classes. So water is a chemical compound that remains. The another condition is electric current. When you pass electric current through the solution. So what is meant by solution? You have to take some salt and you have to add it with water, means we call that salt. Suppose if you are taking salt, the solution is salt solution. If you are taking sugar, that is sugar solution. Clear, children? So it we call that salt as the solute, salt and sugar as a solute, and water we are adding to dissolve, we call that as the solvent. The finished product what we are getting, we call it as solution. So when you allow electricity to pass through it, there will be the separation of the molecules. That process we call it as electrolysis. So some of the chemical change needs electric current, yes, for the conversion. So thus we can conclude that physical contact of the substances, heat, light, electricity, applying pressure, or some of the different conditions needed for chemical changes to occur. So next one, indicators of a chemical change. So what is meant by indicators? Indicators means the changes that are taking place to say there is a chemical change. For example, you are taking broken pieces of eggshell in a test tube, and if you add lemon juice to it, what will happen? That shell will be reacting with lemon juice and it will evolve carbon dioxide. It will evolve bubbles of carbon dioxide. When there is a evolution of carbon dioxide, there may be the bubbles. It's Bovento, Pepsi, Coca-Cola and all. If you open it, what will happen? The fumes will be coming. Yes, effervescence, we call that as the effervescence. That is nothing but you can say the lemon water what we are added to the eggshells undergo chemical change, that the effervescence, bubbles of carbon dioxide came out. Hence we can say evolution of bubbles is serve as a indicator that a chemical change. Then next to one example, when water is added to quicklime, that is calcium oxide, there will be a evolution of lot of heat along with the formation of slaker lime. This is a chemical change and it is indicated by the evolution of heat when the reaction sits in between the quicklime and water. So this quicklime, slaker lime and all, it is very new terms for you. You can take detergent powder, already I told you have to take detergent powder, and you have, if you add some drops of water into it, you can observe the evolution of heat. So that change we call it as endothermic change. Yes, the next one, that is endothermic. How we are taking telling that as endothermic change means that reaction is taking place by observing your body temperature. So every day we cook foodstuffs and clean the empty cooking utensils. Suppose when we leave some cooked utensils with some cooked food and leave them without washing for a day, the next day you can observe some color change and also the smell is fuel smell. Yes, so that is the indication of chemical change. So when iron nail, if you keep it under a atmosphere, open atmosphere, it will be converted into iron oxide. Then curdling of milk, that is conversion of liquid into solid. So these are all the indication of chemical change. Okay, children, the next one is exothermic and endothermic changes. So the chemical reaction will be either endothermic or exothermic. Yes, so you have to take this, and this experiment only have explained. You have to take a pinch of soap powder in one hand and pinch of glucose on the other hand. If you add a few drops of water to soap powder, and what will you can observe the hotness. If you add water to glucose powder, you can observe chillness. So this difference, what is the difference when water is added to soap powder and when water is added to glucose? That is nothing but exothermic and endothermic changes. So in this activity, the warmness in the palm when water is added to soap powder. So we saw that burning of magnesium ribbon also gives out heat and light. Similarly, burning of food also releases heat and light. So such changes in which heat is released are known as exothermic changes. Exo means liberation of heat. Endo means absorption of heat. Clear, children? Clear? So exothermic means evolution of heat. So when water is added to soap powder, you can observe that hotness, that is because of evolution of heat. glucose will take, when it allowed to react with water, you can observe the chillness, that is endothermic change. Yes, so here in your book it has given exothermic and endothermic changes and how the particles are arranged during the process and all. The next one is periodic and non-periodic change. Already have studied mixing of egg shell, baking soda with lemon, everything, the all the examples it is given in picture form. Okay children, the next one is periodic and non-periodic changes. So depending on whether or not a change repeats itself after a definite period of time, it is classified into periodic and non-periodic changes. So changes that repeat themselves after a definite interval of time are called periodic changes. Yes, so rotation and revolution of earth, beating of the heart, clock striking every hour, motion of the seconds hand, minutes can, hour hand or a clock of a clock are some of the examples for periodic changes. So every year you can observe the seasonic changes, that also the periodic change, example of periodic changes. Then non-periodic changes are nothing but the changes that do not repeat themselves after a definite interval of time or occur randomly. We call that as non-periodic changes. So eruption of volcano, occurrence of an earthquake and a streak of lightning flash across the sky during the thunderstorm, running of a batsman between the wickets, movement of legs while dancing or few examples of non-periodic changes. So that's all this lesson children, points to remember. Particle arrangement within the state of matter gets disturbed upon heating. So the disturbance is seen either as expansion or contraction. If it is moving outwards, it is expansion. If it is coming closer, that is contraction. The process in which liquid changes into vapor on heating is called evaporation. A process in which solid changes into liquid on heating is called melting or fusion. A process in which a gas changes into liquid is called condensation. A process in which liquid changes into solid is called freezing. So physical changes are the changes in which only physical properties of a substance undergo change and there is no change in its chemical composition. So solid substances are usually purified by the process of crystallization. Evaporation is the technique used to separate dissolved solids from a solid liquid mixture. And certain solid substances like camphor, naphthalene gets converted into gas directly or without becoming a liquid upon heating by sublimation. Then changes that occur with the formation of new substances with different chemical composition or transformation of a substance into another substance with the evolution or absorption of heat or light energy are termed as chemical changes. So chemical changes will occur with the formation of new substances with different chemical composition or transformation of a substance into another substance with the evolution or absorption of heat. Evolution of heat means exothermic reaction. Absorption of heat means endothermic reaction. If there is any light energy is you can observe, means that is also chemical change. So changes that repeat themselves after a definite interval of time, we call it as periodic change. Changes that do not repeat themselves after a definite interval of time and occur randomly are called non-periodic changes. So changes in which heat is absorbed are known as endothermic reaction. Changes in which heat is released are known as exothermic changes. That's all this lesson children. So you observe in the class. I hope you observe the class in a good manner. So just you go through the video again and again. If there is any doubt, you can ask during the live class children. Okay children, thank you.